As you venture deeper into the tunnels, its structure becomes more and more complex, and its tunnels more narrow. Luckily, you find a secret passage in one of the walls. Hello fellow gamers and crafters, this is Tokrak with a new episode, and this week it's an upgrade to my modular dungeon tile system, and I'm gonna show you how we turn the regular walls into short walls. What you can do with them, I'm gonna show you in a video. Enjoy! So these are the two masters that we need. One is from cardstock, either 1.5 or 2mm, and it's 30mm by 32mm, and the other one is from XPS. It's 7mm height and 20mm by 32mm, can be a little bit bigger. And I just start with the cardboard and measure myself some squares. Get your cutter and start cutting it out. The metal ruler helps as a guide, and I recommend cutting multiple times. It's better than trying to rupture it. I recommend you mark the 32mm side of your square, because otherwise you might have a hard time to distinguish the sides. And then just keep cutting until you have them all in separate pieces. Next, we want to create ourselves something that looks similar to this one, not quite exactly, but similar. I had an XPS foam block left, where I mark myself the orientation of the pieces that I want to cut out, because otherwise I easily would screw it up. And I just write the dimensions on all of the sides. I also mark myself how long I want the block to be, because that determines how many pieces I actually get. And remember, you need twice as many XPS pieces as you have cardboard pieces. And then just start cutting it away with the hot wire cutter. You can also do this with a knife if you want to, it's just more precise with a hot wire cutter. First I cut off the big chunk, and then I separate it into 32mm pieces. And I trim it down to 20mm. Finally, you want to cut them even further down to 7mm. And that should leave you with a nice bunch of pieces. Now it's super easy, we just glue them together with a PVA or white glue. You don't have to use very much, just use a little dab. Put on the XPS tile, move it a little bit, make sure it's straight and flush, and you got it. Once you have the first side glued on, you should put something heavy on it, like a book, and weight it down so it can dry nicely, though it's never going to come off. Once it's dried, we repeat the process on the other side. After both sides have dried off, you use the cutting knife to cut in a 45 degree angle both XPS pieces, but only on one side of your wall piece. And in comparison to your normal wall piece, they look like this. Now it's time to make the brick structure, and I use a soldering iron, but you could also use a ballpoint pen as you like. If you find your wall pieces are too smooth, you can rough them up with a ball of aluminium foil. Now it's time to base coat them with a mix of black acrylic paint and Mod Podge. Put them for drying, and then you can go to the next dry washing step. The painting scheme that I used to paint these short wall pieces is exactly the same as the one that I used for the other pieces. And you can check that out in my painting modular dungeon tiles and walls video. Mix up the color of black, white, and cream. Brush the majority of it off and then start dry brushing your piece. I try to get about 80% coverage here. For the second round of highlights, just use a dab of white, and I used some leftover colors from the previous step. Get rid of the color and carefully apply your next highlight step. Don't be worried if you think you accidentally put on a little bit too much. We're gonna put a black wash step later on, and this will bring all together. So this is our trusted black wash. And just apply it generously. put it for trying, and you made it. You got yourself some short modular wall pieces. Here we can see the short wall pieces in action. And you can see that you can make new shapes that you were unable to do with the big ones. And they make for a very interesting combat. Because suddenly you have a lot of cover. Your spellcasters and your melee fighters can all hide behind. And if the combat gets too intensive, maybe one of your players decides to take the secret exit and just leave. You can use the short modular wall pieces for all sorts of terrain, for example small entrances, or you can use it to highlight other pieces on the board. Or you just make very complicated tunnels. So that's it for the small wall pieces. If you liked all the options that became available with them, maybe you consider leave me a like, subscribe, comment, everything is appreciated. That's it for this week. See you next time, and now it's your turn to craft.